Welcome to The Explainer. Today, we're going to break down the one single idea at the very heart of all economics. It's a concept that quietly shapes every single choice you make, from what you buy at the store to huge government policies that affect millions. All right, let's kick things off with a question that I bet sounds really familiar to you. Have you ever had that feeling where you want a new phone and a vacation, and you're trying to save money, but you know, deep down, you just can't have it all at once? Well, guess what? That feeling, that little bit of tension, it's not just you. You've actually just stumbled upon the foundational problem that the entire massive field of economics was built to understand.
So we have this huge field of study dedicated to this one problem. But what is economics, really? What kind of science are we talking about? Because it might not be what you're picturing in your head.
You know, with something like physics or math, you get these predictable, exact outcomes, right? But economics? That's a whole different ballgame. It's a social science. And what does it study? Us, people. It tries to estimate and understand our often unpredictable behavior. It can build some really powerful models, for sure, but it can never be 100% certain. Okay, so let's dive right into the heart of it all. This is the big one. It's an idea that is so simple, but wow, is it powerful. It pretty much explains, well, almost everything about our economic world.
And the word is scarcity. That's it. At its core, that's what economics is all about. It's the study of how we as people deal with one simple, inescapable fact. Our wants are basically unlimited, but the stuff we have to get those wants, our resources, yeah, those are limited.
Let's just zoom out for a second. Think about a whole country, a government, right? It wants to give its citizens the absolute best of everything. Amazing healthcare, great schools, top-notch security. Those are the unlimited wants. But where does the money come from? Tax revenue. And that is not unlimited. So they have to choose. They simply can't do it all. And you know what? This isn't just some big abstract government problem. It's for you. It's for me. It's for absolutely everyone. We all have a limited salary, right? Or even just a limited number of hours in the day. And we are constantly making choices about how to best use those scarce resources.
All right, to really get a solid grip on this, let's do a little thought experiment. Let's strip away all the complexity of the modern world. No stock market, no global trade. Let's boil the entire world economy down to just one person on a deserted island. So let's meet our guy. We'll call him Danny. And his simple story is going to be the perfect little model to help us see these huge ideas of choice, trade-offs, and the limits that every single one of us deals with.
Okay. So here are the rules in Danny's world. Super simple. He's got one main resource, his time. Let's see, he has 10 hours a day to work. And in that time, he can do two things. He can go fishing, and he's able to catch two fish every hour. Or he can gather coconuts, and he's pretty good at that. He can get 5 coconuts an hour.
So let's just think about the two extremes, right? What if he does nothing but fish all day? 10 hours, 2 fish an hour, that's 20 fish, max. Okay, what if he flips it and only gathers coconuts? 10 hours, 5 coconuts an hour, that's 50 coconuts, max. These two points, they're the absolute edges of his economic world.
But look, life isn't usually all or nothing, is it? Of course he can mix it up and do a bit of both. So what about all the other combinations he could make? To really see this, we're gonna need a picture. So let's map it out.
So imagine a simple graph. We'll put fish on one axis, coconuts on the other. We plot our two maximum points. That's 20 fish and 0 coconuts, and 0 fish and 50 coconuts. Now, we just draw a straight line connecting them. And that line is everything. It's the boundary, the absolute limit of what Danny can possibly produce.
Now, this line has a kind of fancy name in economics. It's called the production possibility curve, or PPC for short. And what's so cool about the PPC is how it takes this abstract idea of limits and choices and makes it totally visual. It's literally a map of Danny's entire economic reality.
Okay, so now we have this line. And what that line does is create 3 distinct zones on our graph. And where you are in relation to that line, whether you're on it, inside it, or outside of it, tells you something incredibly important about how an economy is doing. And I'm not just talking about Danny's little island. This applies to the biggest countries in the world. So let's break it down. Let's look at what each of these zones, efficient, inefficient, and impossible, really means. Because every point on this graph tells a story.
First up, any point that is right on the line. This is what economists call efficient. For example, say Danny splits his day exactly in half, 5 hours fishing, 5 hours gathering. That gets him 10 fish and 25 coconuts. He's used up all 10 of his hours. Nothing is wasted. This is him at peak performance.
Okay, but what if he produces a combination that's inside the curve? Let's say he gets the same 10 fish, but he only gathers 15 coconuts. If you do the math, that only took him 8 hours to produce. This is inefficient. He had 10 hours available, but he only used 8. He's got 2 hours of his resource, his time, that are just unemployed.
And there's a specific word for this concept in economics: idleness. It just means you're not getting the most out of what you have. For Danny, it's a couple of wasted hours. For a real country, this is a huge deal. It could be millions of unemployed people or factories just sitting there doing nothing.
And finally, what about any point that's outside the curve? Well, that's the dream zone, and it's impossible. As much as Danny might want to produce, say, 20 fish and 20 coconuts, it's just not going to happen. He literally does not have enough hours in his day to do it. It's beyond his current resources and abilities.
And that's really the beauty of this whole PPC model. In one simple picture, it shows us the tough realities of our world. It visualizes our limits. That's scarcity. It shows us we always have to make trade-offs. That's choice. And it gives us a really clear target to aim for: efficiency, getting the absolute most from what we have.
So here's the big takeaway. This super simple story about Danny on his island, it scales up perfectly. You can draw a PPC for an entire country, showing its productive limits. And that brings us to the final and maybe the most important thought. Knowing your limits and being efficient within them is step one. But the real goal, the engine of all economic progress, is figuring out how we can grow beyond them. How do we push that entire curve outward?